are back, and we are so excited to have you with us in person and not on that nasty virtual stuff that we had to deal with for so many years. So we are excited, as you can tell. We have a lot planned for you today, and I'm going to help our students along the way. We're trying to feature our fifth graders today and helping them get ready for middle school, as well as preparing our fourth graders to take on leadership roles when our fifth graders move along. Your master of ceremonies today is Roman Evans. Roman is one of our honors choir and CUC class members. He is a posture of great things to come. I get so excited watching my students grow and become men and women, and these kids are those that I'm going to follow for many years. So we're going to get started. We ask that you be gracious and understand that we have a lot of students to maneuver. And we have reserved seats for our police officers up front and our veterans. Please, guys, if you want to come up and have your seats here in the second row, we have reserved seats for you. So today we want you to welcome the Singing Seahawks to Myrtle Beach Elementary School, and we celebrate our veterans and first responders.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Myrtle Beach Elementary School's second annual celebration of veterans and first responders. Please stand with me as we begin our ceremony.
Thank you. and to our guests, I hope you truly enjoy our program today, as our students really do appreciate all that you have done for us. Thank you.
Support for the
delegation went to Washington, D.C. to convince lawmakers to make the change. Today we celebrate all of our military. Say thank you for your service.
Good morning. there, Carmen, Tito, please all of you stand up. For both of the couple of children.
Ready? Two.
much. The honor is ours, truly. Next to the podium is Anna Kate Pittman, and she's going to make a correction.
We are honored to have today with us Representative Kate Pittman as he serves citizens in this great city, as we greatly appreciate all he does.
Give me liberty or give me debt. Through these arguments and discussions, in what I believe is one of the greatest doctors ever to have been written. John Adams, Benjamin Franklin, Thomas Jefferson, the Declaration of Independence. We hold these truths to be self-evident. That all men and women are created equal. They have the right to life, happiness, pursuit of happiness, life. But the very, that's the preamble. And one of the things that I think the military, they do, they serve an honor and they protect, is this last line of the Declaration of Independence. We support this declaration with firm reliance of a divine providence that we mutually swear to each other our lives, our fortunes, and our honor. From that moment, our military has served fault for our freedoms, for our rights. You don't agree with somebody, guess what? You get to express your content. You don't believe the same way someone else believes? Your military men and women serve on this land and in foreign countries to protect the right from your disagreement, to protect your voice, to protect your way of life. They are here. They have seen horrors. They have stories that should shake meaning to their souls. They've lost limbs, lacerations, cuts, wounds. Some have even what they have lost their life, what they were able to call the last true nation of the nation, sacrificing their life for this great country. It is something that is not lost on me. I don't feel honored to be here. I don't feel worthy to be standing here after our commander's meeting. I definitely feel honored to support worthy to stand up with our servicemen. My sacrifice, I don't get to see my family as much when I'm in session. And that is a sacrifice. But it pales in comparison to the sacrifices that our first responders and our military endure day in and day out. So, I want to say this. I always like to speak to our children. I want y'all to know this. Your teachers, your parents, listen to them. Please listen to them. We always strive for perfection. We want to get the A's on the test. And we make sure we study hard and do all that stuff. We want to make sure we prepare ourselves. But also remember, when we don't reach that 100, when we fail to attend something, learn the lessons. You can learn great lessons from failures. You can also learn from successes, but sometimes when life's hard and life is tough, failures, and how do you react? You get back up. You stand up and you fight more. You learn from your mistakes. And know this, the teachers believe in you. They've chosen a career that is not highly regarded as it should be. Your parents, whether they get upset with you because you let the light on in the house or you left your room, cerebral of sense of the same. They believe in you. They have faith in you. I have faith in you. I believe in you. When times are dark, just remember that. You will always have people in your life that believe and have faith in you. I thank our military. I thank our first responders. We all owe our lives to you, our rights, our freedoms. Just a speech can't be enough. Can't be enough gratitude for you all. The children, men, women, please, you see a man with a military hat on, like our commander, go up to him, tell him thank you for their service. You see a firefighter, a police officer, an EMT worker, go up to him, tell him thank you for your service. They have sacrificed more than we can ever imagine. In closing, God bless our military, God bless our first responders, God bless South Carolina, and God bless the United States of America. Thank you.
Students to
First responders are vastly important to us. We would now like to take a moment and honor each of these heroes.
Thank you. Thank you all so very much. This will be very brief, but it's very important. We know that Ms. Nutter now has for 2 years recognized our veterans and our first responders, and this year we are proud to announce to her that the VFW will be announcing her as one of the national National Citizen Education Teacher of the Year awards. So. You help make this school just an incredible place. Thank you.